In this illustration, we intend to simulate the stress within the soil due to the point load in the Abaqus software. In this example, a vertical point load of 10 kN is to be applied to the top surface of the soil, and we are going to calculate the increase of stress having been caused within the soil. And here in the right picture, you can observe the stress having been created within the soil in different depth. Actually, we intend to simulate the example 3-4 from some Helwani book in the Abaqus software and compare the results gained from the Abaqus software with the Buzinesque solution. I'll enter the Abaqus software for simulation. I click on Create Part. Here I intend to create the geometric shape of soil. The geometric shape of the soil is actually a cylinder, and since that is symmetric, we can model the soil in form of an axisymmetric. From here, I will select deformable and shell, enter the rough size of the tracing page as 5 and continue. I'll draw a rectangle. The radius of the cylinder is 1 meter, and it is 2 meters high, 1 meter, and 2 meters, and done. Then I'll select partition from the tools menu, then face and sketch. Draw a vertical line in this manner and enter the distance between these 2 points as 0.1 and click on Done. The reason why we've created partition into the model is that we can use finer mesh in the zone around the point load. I'll enter Property Module, click on Create Material. I intend to define the properties of soil. I select Elasticity and Elastic from the Mechanical menu. The soil has been supposed to be in the form of linear elastic with a Young modulus equal to 1 multiplied by 10 to the power of 7 kilo Pascal and a Poisson ratio of 0.3. I'll enter Young modulus equal to 1 multiplied by 10 to the power of 10 Pascal and a Poisson ratio of 0.3 and OK. Then I'll click on Create Section, select Solid and Homogeneous, Continue and OK. I will click on Assign Section, select the soil, and Done, and OK. I'll enter Assembly Module, click on Create Instance, and enter the soil into the Assembly section. I will enter Step Module, click on Create Step. Here, select Static General and Continue. The analysis will be done in nonlinear form. I will enter initial increment size equal to 0.1 seconds and OK. I will enter load module, click on create boundary condition. From here select symmetry, anti-symmetry and continue. I select this line and done. As you observe in the picture, this line is the soil axis of symmetry. So I'll tick on x-symmetric option here, and okay, I will click on create boundary condition again, select displacement rotation from here and continue. I'll select the bottom of the soil, done. Close the boundary condition of U1 and U2 to it, and OK. Again, I click on create boundary condition, select displacement rotation and continue. I will select this line, done. Close the boundary condition of U1 for it, and OK. I'll click on create load, select step 1 from here, then concentrated force and continue. I'll select this point, done. A 10 kilonewton vertical point load will be applied to the top surface of the soil. I'll enter the point load equal to negative 10,000 newton and OK. Then I'll enter mesh module, click on seed edge, select these lines, done. Here I'll select by number and then single. I'll enter number of elements equal to 13 and bias ratio equal to 4 and OK. Then I'll select these lines, done. Then click on select. Again, I will select these lines and done. I'll enter the number of elements equal to 40, bias ratio equal to 5, and OK. Then I'll select these lines, done. Consider the number of 7 elements for them, and OK. After that, I'll click on mesh part, and yes, in this manner. As you observe, we used finer mesh in the zone around the point load where there is a stress concentration, and that's quite clear in this picture. I'll enter job module, click on create job, continue, OK, and click on submit. The analysis was done successfully, so I'll click on result. The purpose of this analysis is to calculate the stress within the soil due to the point load in the Abaqus software and compare that with Buzinesque solution. Actually, we intend to draw these two diagrams in the Abaqus software. In these two diagrams, the vertical stress has been drawn in different depth. I'll enter Abaqus software, click on tools menu, path and create, continue, then add before. First I'll select this node, then this one, done, and OK. I'll click on create XY data, from here select path and then continue. I'll select undeformed, tick on include intersection option. From here select the last frame, select the vertical stress or the same S22 and OK, and then click on plot. Here the unit of stress is Pascal, but it is kilopascal in the diagram in Sam Helwani book. So we should convert the unit of stress from Pascal to kilopascal. To do so, I'll click on create XY data. From here select operate on XY data and continue. I will select this diagram and divide that by 1000. In this manner, the unit of stress will be converted from Pascal to kilopascal. And OK. As you observe here, the starting point of the diagram is nearly close to 0.1. So I'll select these quantities here, the starting point of which is close to 0.1, copy and paste them in the Abaqus software. The first column is depth based on meter. And the second column is the vertical stress, the unit of which is a kilopascal. I'll select this column, copy and paste that here in this manner. Then I'll select these two columns and click on this diagram from the insert menu. Here I'll click on values in reverse order. As you observe the diagram having been obtained from the Abaqus software is quite the same as that one gained from Sam Helwani book. I will enter the Abaqus software here. I intend to draw the vertical stress within a distance of 0.1 meter from the point load. I will select Path and Create from the Tools menu. Continue. Add before. First, I select this node. Then this one. Done. And OK. I will click on Create XY Data. Select Path. Here, select Path 2. And click on Plot. I will click on Create XY Data, then on Operate XY Data. I'll select this diagram and divide that by 1000. In this manner, the unit of stress will be converted from Pascal to kilopascal. I'll click on Edit. As you observe here, the starting point of the diagram is not from zero, but it is nearly close to zero. And you will realize that if you look at the picture. Therefore, I will not select zero here, and instead we'll select other quantities, copy them, and paste them in the Excel software. I will right click on the diagram, click on Select Data, click on Add. Then select this column. Then this column. And OK. In this manner, as it can be observed, the results gained from the Abaqus software are quite the same as those obtained from Sam Helvani book. Also, as you observe, both diagrams are quite conforming on each other, indicating that the results gained from the Abaqus software are quite right and proper.